Ekipa televizije Reuter uspjela se probiti do Guče Gore, gdje se nalazi jedan od najstarijih katoličkih samostana u Srednjoj Bosni. Tamo su snimili tragične posljedice napada muslimanskih snaga koje nisu štedjele ni starce, ni svećenike, ni časne sestre. Na kontrolnoj točci UNPROFOR-a u Starom Grabovcu hrvatske vlasti noćas su prihvatile veliku skupinu od 1500 Hrvata koje su muslimanske snage protjerali iz Srednje Bosne. Naša ekipa dočekala je tu kolonu iznemoglih ljudi koji su oružjem protjerani iz svojih domova.
Sam pobjegla od noža, ništa više ne znam.
Tako govori ova žena izbjegla pred muslimanima. Malo je tko od 1630 žena, djece i staraca koji su prošle noći kamionima Međunarodnog crvenog križa stigli u Novsku i mogao reći više. Progon, strah, 3 dana putovanja, umor, čini se, otupili su sve osjećaje.
Ne znam, ništa ne mogu pričati.
U mojoj kući sada ili žive muslimani ili su je zapalili, govori pak ova žena sliježući ramenima. Prema svjedočenju prognanika, većina se civila i stradnika nije uspjela izvući, osim manjeg broja onih koji su se nekoliko dana prije povukli prema okolnim selima. Tvrde kako su u Travniku muslimani počinili pravi masakr.
Ostalo je dosta komšija. Moj je muž poginuo. Od Djevera mi sin ranjen. Djevir mi ranjen. Rođak mi ranjen. Dijete njegovo ranjeno. To su svi muslimani pobili.
To je užas bio. Užas.
Svi se čude kako su se Srbi prema njima ponašali više manje korektno, sve do činjenice da je 750 sposobnih muškaraca zarobljeno i odvedeno u logor Manjača.
Bolje krenuti prema njima nego prema muslimanu. Znate bolje?
A kako su vas oni dočekali na srpskoj strani?
Krajem na prvi pogled je bilo sve dobro dok nije odvojilo sposobne ljude.
Na srpskoj strani?
Da.
I gdje su sad oni?
A ti su ljudi očišli dole prema Banja Luki, Manjači, Logor, navodno razni.
I ljudi.
Četvorodnevno putovanje izbjeglih Hrvata ovdje nije završeno. Od Travnika preko Vlašića i Banja Luke, preko okupiranih dijelova Hrvatske, zatim Novska, Zagreb, Split. Cilj je, nadaju se oni privremeni, zapadna Hercegovina. Večera se očekuje kako će s Vlašića stići još oko 2000 hrvatskih izbjeglica, a tvrdi se kako spas čeka još oko 6000 Travničkog područja.
It's more than a few burning houses now. This is a whole village on fire. Guča Gora in the hills above Travnik. Put to the torch as hundreds of Croats fled their homes. When British troops tried to get into the village, they came under fire. Attacks on their armored vehicles are happening more and more. The British troops found more than 200 Croat civilians besieged around the village church. The soldiers managed to persuade the Muslim forces to put down their weapons and let the villagers escape. Today, refugees were still coming down from the burning villages into the Lashvar Valley. Some found space at a school near Vitez. Many others are being moved to towns further east. Croat soldiers are preparing for attacks on the villages around Vitez. Overnight, they built new defensive positions, expecting the Bosnian army to sweep down the valley. Martin Brunt, Sky News, Central Bosnia.
Vijeće obrane tvrdi u svom današnjem priopćenju da su u selu Maljne kod Travnika muslimanske postrojbe 8. ovoga mjeseca streljale 32 Hrvata. Pozivajući se na izjave jednog preživjelog svjedoka, u HVO priopćuju da su preostali Hrvati iz sela Maljna odvedeni u nepoznatom smjeru.
800-year-old monastery of St. Francis was where the villagers sought sanctuary, guarded overnight by British warriors which had been driven to their rescue. Inside, 187 Croat men, women and children, too terrified to leave, for fear of being slaughtered by rampaging Muslim soldiers. For the British Army commander trying to reach Guchagura, the road was fraught with danger and problems. "Why don't you help us?" said this group of Muslims, who showed him a young boy's body to prove how they were suffering too. Eventually, the reinforcement warriors were allowed to move on after promises that once the trapped Croats had been taken to safety, the British would return to help Muslim people. In Guchagura, those brave enough to venture outside were preparing to bury their dead. 7 in all killed in yesterday's battle. There was no priest there, and so the army chaplain took charge of the funeral service.
Dust to dust.
The gunmen in the surrounding hills tried to prevent these people from paying their last respects. But as British Army snipers took cover, the chaplain read on.
Hallowed be thy name.
The attack continued until the army replied with 340 rounds from their chain guns. It was then that the commanding officer decided to evacuate the monastery, giving orders for the families to be transported inside his armored warriors. "Thank you," they said as they clutched their children and a few belongings. They were leaving their homes, but they were all together. The most delicate of passengers were tenderly hoisted aboard by burly British squaddies. It was the first real test in Bosnia for the man in charge, and it's being regarded as a huge success.
If we can get these people out, we'll achieve something. It is a small attempt, and I'm well aware that around this whole area of conflict, there are many other people stuck in these circumstances.
The families are in the safety of a refugee center in Nova Bila, along with thousands more homeless people. They will always remember the Monastery of St. Francis, but many may never return. Terry Lloyd, News at 10, Central Bosnia.
Before the latest ceasefire was agreed, the battle around Travnik continued. On the Croat front line north of the town, HVO forces held what ground they could against the Muslim infantry, but they were taking casualties. Since the start of the ceasefire, prompted by the appointment of a new Bosnian army chief, there have been some exchanges in the hills, but the fighting was only sporadic. Refugees are still leaving the villages where the fighting's been heaviest. But the shock of being driven from their homes is turning to anger. Some turned on the local Croat commander, demanding the soldiers go back and fight for the lost territory. Aid agencies have been able to supply simple bedding, but the refugees arrived in Vitez to find there's a growing water shortage. British warrior crews who rescued 200 civilians trapped in a village church the day before were on standby to try to help others.
British UN troops have been handed a long list of villages, Croat and Muslim, where besieged civilians want help in escaping.
Soldiers went to one village but found it deserted and the livestock slaughtered, probably by the fleeing villagers.